This just looks weird. It's too bluish. Let's change colors. Now that's better. The Room is a 2003 drama that is written, directed, produced and starring Tommy Wiseau, Greg Sestero, and this film has become a true cult classic for all the wrong reasons. This is essentially the best worst movie ever made, and I love it to death. I've seen it countless times and it is a blast every single one of those times. The story is fairly simple. It basically is about this perfect human being named Johnny, and he's played by Tommy Wiseau. And he has a beautiful house with a beautiful girlfriend, with lots of great friends, and he is a great human being. Unfortunately, his girlfriend, Lisa, she's a total bitch, and she's cheating on him with his best friend, Mark. And so we get this weird love triangle and look on love, betrayal, infidelity and friendship. And this movie is truly horribly made, from the production design with this incredibly awful set with paintings and frames of spoons just laying there because they had to pick up whatever they could very cheaply. The cinematography is horrendous, it is very static, a lot of wide shots and then a couple of close-ups, but it never feels cinematic in any way. It is an awful movie, and I love it, because what makes this film, compared to more modern ones, because recently the so bad it's good subgenre, whatever you want to call it, types of movies, it has become almost too self-aware, and it lacks the charm that this one has and others like Birdemic, because what makes this film successful compared to other ones is that Tommy Wiseau, the director, the producer, the writer, he was thinking that he was actually doing something great, something thought-provoking, something deep. And the fact that everyone laughed at the screening, at the first screening, and that it was a complete misfire and a gigantic disaster, it destroyed him. It's a terrible thing, just creating something that you love, that you think is going to be loved by everyone else, and seeing that everyone is shitting upon it. So it was hard to take for him, but he started to accept what the movie basically was, and backpedal, saying things like, no, it was always going to be a so bad it's good comedy. Yeah, no one believes him about that, but still, the movie was made with a lot of heart, with a lot of passion by him. Even though everything is completely horrible, even the sound editing, which is something that barely ever happens in the infamous flower shop scene, the sound editing is god-awful, and this movie is a lot of fun. And what sells it is the acting itself, is the story itself, because this movie has a story that pretty much never moves on. We have probably 50 minutes that are filler, where things happen that don't really matter in the end. You know, it's so much fun to witness, with these characters that come and go, actors that actually had to drop off, they finished their schedule before they actually filmed all of their scenes, so we have different characters that aren't even introduced that have to say another actor's lines. It's so good to witness every time. There is always something new, some little detail of awfulness that you find. And Tommy Wiseau delivers a fantastically weird performance, starting from his accent. It's just weird. It's you can't really pick and understand where he's from, but it just works. In the context of the film, it works. And the characters themselves, they're portrayed and written in such a weird way, like they always have to remind you of some things, that, for example, Lisa is engaged to Johnny and they're gonna be married and she's gonna be his future wife. And then we have the fact that Mark always has to remind us before sleeping with Lisa, he always has to say, oh, but Johnny is my best friend, every single time. You know, Johnny is my best friend, I can't do this. They say it countless times, and the oh hi Mark and different things that Tommy says, it's just so weird but so endearing. And that's the thing about this film. Even though it is horribly made, it has a charm, a certain earnestness that is lost in a lot of other movies. Something like Sharknado, it's made to be bad. This one wasn't. This one has a lot of passion behind it, and I love that. And also the story itself, as much as it is horrible, it always gets me thinking about some relationships that I witnessed on a daily basis, of these weird love triangles, like the best friend who is cheating with the best friend's girlfriend. I've seen these things, I'm seeing these things, and it's just like some things, even though they're horribly portrayed, they're also pretty close to reality, like the reactions, the girlfriend who is never happy when she's with the boyfriend, but then whenever the other guy comes into the room, she instantly becomes alive, pretty much, with those fuck me eyes, if you know what I'm saying. Those things are actually pretty spot on, even though they are horribly portrayed. They're not too far off from reality, and that's what I like about this film. It feels alien, and at the same time, very human and very real. It's just a ton of fun, so definitely, definitely, definitely watch The Room. If you're one of those that only wants to watch, let's say, mediocre good movies, like the ones that you go, oh, that was a fun time, yay, this one is bad, and if you don't like watching purposely bad movies like this one, or Birdemic, or others, you're not going to like this. But I think that if you go into this wanting to have fun and to laugh at something, you're gonna have a blast, especially with friends. It's a ton of fun. So definitely, definitely, definitely watch The Room. But still, guys, if you watched The Room, do you like or do you dislike it? And which is your favorite quote? Tell me in the comments below. Thanks for watching, or to like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.